Hey, YouTube, we're back again.
That's right, we're back again. This is Sunshine.
And E.
All right.
We are here.
Right. We have something a little special. I guess all of them special, but this is something, I guess we, because we had some requests from our last video, we get some requests to do some more or something different, but it's actually the same group. We did something on Hanson, Mbop, and that triggered some comments, right?
Yeah, check us some comments and, you know, told us we should listen to some more. But we did also on our Mbop channel, this, I said the song that I most love of the Hanson was With You in Your Dreams.
Yeah.
Or, yeah, With You in Your Dreams.
Oh, yeah.
And I've never seen any of their videos until prior to us doing the Mbop one. So, because I love this song so much, I wanted to see the video.
Right. And this is, I guess, they said it was a grandmother that someone passed, and this was written for them. Do you remember?
It's somebody. I can't remember.
Okay, it was somebody in their family that passed on, and they wrote. This is, I guess, someone, if you listen to a couple of, there's another song that they talk about, I guess, someone that passed or something happened to them in the school they went to. And they were saying, like, where the picture's not in the yearbook. I think it's called Yearbook, is a song. And so they, I guess when they started off, they did a lot of songs that, you know, had to deal with. Most artists do, but just more directly that dealt with some things in their life. But we're going to get started. And I've got some other comments I want to make. but right now we're going to get into the videos with you in your dreams. With You in Your Dreams, right? It's weird because when you listen to the song, if you listen enough, they could probably title the song three or four different titles, you know, because the way they did the song and what stands out to you. So let's get into this one.
Hit the like button, subscription button, notification button, and the share button.
Mm-hmm.
Let's go.
We dedicate to our late grandmother.
Oh,
it's a song called "With You in Your Dreams."
There you go.
Okay. I just want to say I didn't watch this. I just listened to the comments, isn't it? Like I was at this great
moment. Yeah, they said in the comments.
But I see this is live too. Okay.
Don't look. Song.
Right. And it's weird because it was gonna automatically go to the next video, and it's they're a little older, and
was it?
Yeah. But it's cool. But that's what I really enjoy about watching this group, especially after we watched the first one. We got the comments. It shows you kind of the way that maybe life should go when you have. That's why I never really, unless a teenager is doing something that's just going to lead them down a bad road or just doing something that's illegal, things like that, I kind of allow them to have their space. All these guys have the long hair, kind of symbolizing freedom, and, you know, just kind of doing their thing. They didn't do no crazy stuff, just was, you know, just kind of doing their thing. But someone put in the comments said, I think all three of them are actually grown up, got married, have children, you know what I'm saying? So it's there's a process, a life process that we all go through. And I think the jobs of parents or other adults, teachers, people that's in power or in positions to kind of help them, not to prevent them to being themselves, but just make sure they don't call outside the line until they can get to the point where they're adult, make them great decisions. And I haven't heard a lot of crazy things about these guys. And it's just they went through that process, now they're men and fathers and husbands, so you know it's great to hear that, you know, in a group, this particular group.
Yeah, I liked them when they were younger. I don't know much about them as adults, but I couldn't imagine them being great, you know, people, you know, turn into great, wonderful, you know, people. Their voices, I love it. I just have that good soft tone in this particular mm-hmm. song, and to be so talented at such a young age. I mean, their vocals, their instrumental, you know, I wonder if they wrote their own songs, right. Who's to say, you know, I just think they're
I'm sure nice they wrote some of the songs, if not most of them, or
this one I guess had to because they said it was about,
you know, or sometimes, you know, like you have people that write books and say, I've got a book coming out. They didn't necessarily write, they got with people that kind of, you know, put together, but they just brought that story forward. So it could have been working in concert with someone to produce these songs, you know, writing wise. But it's still, I'm sure it's, you know, different because you can see them getting into a song, getting really emotional about songs. So it's, you know, great group. I really, really wish they got an opportunity to do more when they were, you know, back at that time. You can see this says 1998, and it's about the time that we was really, really listening to them. And I think I wish they would have had more opportunities to showcase their skills to everyone instead of, you know, being viewed a different way. But it's a good thing. But it worked out. I guess they're still performing, they said, some people said. And so they're still, you know, getting out, doing what they like, and seem to grow up to be great people. So that's the main thing, you know. But that's going to be Hanson with you in your dreams. one of a, and to be honest with you, I'm going to tell you, be honest with you, I've either heard or played this song at least once a year since that 1998. I've heard that song. I just love this song. I just love the vocals. There's a couple songs I listen to of them from time to time. So it's not a year go by that I don't listen to one or two or three of their songs. I just think they were just great vocalists and great song, you know, writers or singers or whatever. So,
I mean, I actually incorporated this song in a personal video that I made.
Right.
You know, so I've always liked the song. Mm. Yeah.
So, appreciate you all, checking us out, letting us share our reaction to Hanson, and maybe we might do another one, because like I said, they had like five or six of them that I really love, so maybe we may come back and do another one. But for now, please do us a favor, like, subscribe, hit the notification bell, and also share, and I do believe that's it.
Thanks for listening to Sunshine and E.